So back here with Gerrald Emeagwali, second half of the footy show, back to the Euros as well. So what are you looking forward to with the coming upcoming games then? We've got Germany in action. It's going to be good fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
Seeing what Germany can do for this Euros tournament, given that they've won it, what, three times. Looking forward to seeing the Germans?
Yes, I'm looking forward to that group entirely. Not just the Germans, but
that's the best
I want to see what Werner does, because there's talk of him being offered to Real Madrid. And I want to see what sort of, because he didn't have a great season at Chelsea, but one season doesn't really say a player is not good if he's just coming to the Premiership.
Yeah.
So I'm waiting to see what he does. Kai Havertz, we're beginning to see that he, you know, the sort of talent he has and why Chelsea paid all that money for him, especially with the way he won the Champions League for them. So now for Germany, can he sort of replicate that form for them that he's beginning to pick up and he had before joining Chelsea? And can Werner score those goals? We know they have a good keeper, they've got a good defence, they usually have a good midfield, but it's usually sometimes the goals. They let down their own selves in terms of goals. They could score goals, but they end up letting teams beat them. Of recent also, Germany hasn't been the same. Since the days of Podolski and whatnot, I'll say the German team has sort of taken that step back when they come into competitions before you expect them to be one of the favourites to win every time.
Yeah,
but that sort of changed over the last few years and sort of gone unnoticed now because of we've seen other teams emerge like France and Belgium, teams that are sort of already big before.
Yeah, I mean, who would have thought that we'd be thinking about France, you know, winning it yet again? France, you know, they've eclipsed a lot of other European football teams, haven't they, in the last kind of 15 years?
Yeah, they have a lot of talent coming out every time.
Unbelievable.
They have about 10 strikers that they could possibly use, well, maybe 30 midfielders they could use. It's just crazy because the French league, a lot of the time, you have people from England going over there to shop for players. And when I say people, I mean teams. When these people come to the Premier League, they get different skills. They get taught differently by different managers.
Yeah.
They play in different sort of competitions. And even if it's a championship or the Champions League, they're going to pick up something new. Now, taking that back to their country, that's more for them to work with. Whereas people that are sort of like, I don't know, countries that don't really have their players, you know, playing in other countries outside, don't really have that sort of versatile, you know, players or sort of alternative, you know, players that can be in different positions and play differently.
Yeah,
for them.
Yeah. So what about Portugal then? The title holders, that's going to be interesting. Ronaldo's probably Ronaldo's last tournament, you would think, given he's, what, 35, 36 now?
He'll probably play one or two more before he quits.
You think?
Yeah.
Tournaments?
Yeah.
Right, interesting, yeah. Because Ibrahimovic from Sweden, he's not playing, he's injured, isn't he, I think. But you do think Ronaldo, what, will go on to his 40, playing for Portugal. Interesting, right.
Ronaldo, you just need to give him... The thing about Ronaldo is going to probably come down as he gets older is his speed, his mobility. But in terms of his sharpness and the goal threat he carries, he's always going to be in that team. Whether if it's just going to be for the last 5 minutes of a game, you know if you have Ronaldo there, head, foot, left, right, whatever it is, if he gets that ball in that good position, he's going to score. And yeah, he might be that kind of player that just needs to get the ball there, but that's what happens when you get older. You sort of kept up front there where the ball's just delivered to you and you come on sort of towards the end of the game and you only spend or you play for only key games to sort of balance the nerves of other players around you, especially the young ones.